Peace everyone, Unmask Art here, and today I'm going to do a comparative review of the top four brands of pastel pencils. With all the choices out there, how could you ever know which to choose? Well, today we're going to find out, but first make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on all future burning life questions. Anyways, the goal of this video is to give you some insight on which pastel pencil brand you should most consider buying and possibly which to avoid. First up is the fan favorite, the Stabilo Carbothellos. Unlike the other brands I'll be looking at today, I've been using the Carbothellos for a couple years now, and there is a reason I continue both using and recommending these pencils. They are a standout performer, but they also have a remarkable price. You can get the whole set in this lovely tin case for just around $70, but let's talk about performance. The demonstration you see here is a simple still life with some lovely bold colors on Clairefontaine pastel matte. The Carbothellos have a smooth, chalk-like feel to them when working with them. This makes coloring with them effortless and soothing. And though the color selection is limited to 60, they somehow manage to give you everything you need. Really, the only two minor drawbacks to these pencils is the struggle to get sharp, clean details because of just how soft they are. The other is that out of the 60 pencils, about 12 of them have a lower light fastness, meaning they are more prone to fading over time. Aside from that, I have no doubt I will continue to use, buy, and recommend this set to all of my students and those interested in getting into pastels. I give the Carbothellos a solid 8 out of 10. Up next, we have the Pitt Pencils by Faber-Castell. The Pitt Pencils were actually the first pastel pencil I had ever tried, though that was quite a long time ago in only a few colors. I decided to get the full set just for this review. Just like the Carbothellos, the entire set is only 60 colors for about $68. These also come in a nice little tin case with a very easy removable trays, much better than the Carbothellos actually. But enough about the case, how do they perform? First off, the color selection is spectacular. The color range they put in this set is just so ideal. This makes color matching a breeze. Now, since this was really the first time using them, I noticed just how different they feel on the paper in comparison to the Carbothellos. These pencils feel much more oily than their chalky counterpart. When I was doing my initial layers, I was actually growing concerned that they would not blend as smooth as the Carbothellos. However, that concern quickly turned to amazement after I started blending them. In spite of their somewhat sticky feel, they blend wonderfully. The other thing I noticed about them was they hold their tip much better than the Carbothellos. This makes getting fine details and sharp lines remarkably easier. So what are the drawbacks? Well, again, about 14 of the pencils have questionable light fastness, which is a couple more than the Carbothellos. But for the price of both of these sets, nobody gets to complain. The other drawback is the color vibrancy. As you can see in the demonstration, the lime and apple have a much less saturated green and red. The colors lack a certain boldness that the Carbothellos just doesn't struggle with. However, the sharp detail that these pencils can achieve will make them a valuable addition to your collection. I give the Pitt pencils a 7 out of 10 because I think they make a better secondary set rather than a primary set. Up next is the Derwent Pastel Pencils. Now, unlike the Carbothellos and Pitt pencils, I had neither owned nor used these pencils before this review, so the experience was brand new for me. You can buy the full set of 72 in either a wood box or tin like the two previous sets for about $100 or $78 respectively. However, let me quickly say that the wooden case is not worth it. If you decide to buy this set, get the tin case. I do my best to be objective on my channel. If not objective, I am at least completely honest. I regret wasting my money on this set of Derwent pencils. I would like to be talking about how they performed and how they feel at this point. I enjoy being positive, but these pencils were just way too disappointing. In fact, I'm still a little shocked at how much I dislike these pencils. Let's just talk about the wooden case really quick. It is the worst design you could have come up with. There are no removable trays, and the bars holding the pencils are held in by weak magnets that were unattached when I opened the case. So my very first experience with these pencils was picking them up off the floor once they were scattered everywhere. Now to the more relevant part. I had to spend a full 50 minutes sharpening the 15 or so pencils I needed to color the still life for the demonstration. Why, you may ask? Because the wood used in these pencils is so incredibly hard that it is impossible to sharpen with any conventional pencil sharpener. I am no stranger to hand sharpening pencils with a blade, and with wood this hard, it's just a safety hazard. Not to mention the core of the pencil in nearly all that I sharpened repeatedly broke off while trying to sharpen them. I really don't want to spend much more time talking about these pencils. From the demonstration, you can see the low saturation, similar to the Pitt pencils, so not amazing there. Once they were sharpened, they felt okay. Just okay, though. I did like the opaqueness of the darker colors, however. But there are still about 9 questionable light fastness pencils in this set, so I am giving the Derwent pastel pencils a 3 out of 10. Because no art supply should be so unenjoyable to work with. Last but not least is the Caran d'Ache-Genève pastel pencils. This is another set that I had zero experience with until I decided to do this review. The full set, unlike previous set, only comes in a wooden box. However, this wooden box is actually quality. I mean, for the low price of $270, it ought to be. That was sarcasm, just in case you weren't sure. This case comes with nice wooden removable trays, and with no doubt your pencils are secure, unlike the Derwent pencils. One other notable feature is just how thick these pencils are, which at first was a little annoying as they did not fit in my electric sharpener, which all the other brands did. However, the build quality of the Genèves is so good that a standard hand crank sharpener worked like a charm and avoided breaking a single pencil even once. Let's just say I was impressed, and the thought that they didn't fit in my preferred sharpener no longer bothered me. Now let's talk about their performance. I posted the final picture of the demonstration you see several days before writing my review, and nearly everyone liked the look of the Genèves in comparison to all the others. The second most liked was the Carbothellos. As you can see, the colors are rich and vibrant, but how do these pencils feel? Well, they feel as good as they look. They have a more chalky feel, similar to the Carbothellos, but they're even smoother. In fact, they may be the smoothest pencil I've ever dragged across any surface. It was very pleasing to use these pencils, and with only 4 of the pencils having a lower light fastness rating, you can rest easy knowing your work won't fade. The color selection is beyond words. I actually find it rather amusing that Caran d'Ache has more colors in their pastel pencils than their luminance pencils. The other shocking realization I had while using these pencils was that I did not sharpen them once during the coloring process. Unlike the Carbothellos, which require several, so in spite of the chalkiness, you can indeed get the level of detail that the Pitt pencils offers. So I give the Caran d'Ache-Genèves a 9 out of 10, because do your pencils really need to be that thick? Well, there you have it, everyone. 4 of the top pastel pencil brands. But before I close out this video, I need to give a shout out to the real MVP of this review, and that is my Jacquard Electric Auto Stop Pencil Sharpener. I know a lot of you have been anticipating the release of the name of my infamous sharpener, but I needed to make sure it was battle tested before endorsing it. And let me tell you, I have put this sharpener through enough to justify a restraining order, and it has yet to break a tip off of one of my pencils. So there you have it. Hope you found this video helpful. If you did, let me know by commenting below and giving the video a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe and come join me on my Drawing Journal live streams every Monday. Hope to see you there. Take care. Peace. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you are interested in learning more pastel or colored pencil techniques, join me over on my Patreon page where I do live tutorials every Tuesdays and Thursdays. Hope to see you there.